With the 737 MAX now in service, it's easy to forget the original series aircraft launched in the late 1960s. Well, unless you're an avgeek. Then you'll already be well aware that this is one of the major complaints regarding the latest generation of the 737. Nonetheless, it's quite noteworthy how small the original 737 series was when compared to the 737s flying today. We go back in history to compare and contrast the original 737 with the newest models. The Boeing 737 was envisioned in the 1960s as a supplement and eventual replacement to the popular Boeing 727. The first variant, the 737-100, flew in April 1967 and entered service with Lufthansa in February 1968. It brought many advances for Boeing, such as having aircraft powered by just two wing-mounted engines and the six-abreast seating that is common today. It didn't bring size, though, as it was just 28.65 meters long, offering a typical two-class capacity of just 85 and a maximum exit limit of 124. Comparing it to the latest 737s, consider that the shortest 737 MAX variant, the Dash 7, is 35.56 meters long, and the largest 737 MAX 10, which took its first flight in June 2021, is 43.8 meters long. We should note, however, that at the time of this video's production, these aircraft have yet to enter service. The 737-100 didn't last long. Only 30 aircraft were built and most saw service with Lufthansa. Early in the 737 program, United Airlines had requested a larger model, which was developed as the 737-200. It stretched the fuselage by almost 2 meters, taking capacity up to 102. The Dash 200 entered service with United in April 1968, and Boeing sold over 1,100 examples. The Classic, Next Generation, and 737 MAX series are larger than these 737 originals, and there has never been a return to the size of the 737-100. Looking at the size of the 737-100 raises an interesting point about today's narrowbodies. Boeing and Airbus aircraft in this category have gradually increased in size over the years. However, a market for smaller regional aircraft that offers a capacity similar to smaller original 737s is proving popular. The smallest Embraer E170, for example, is just under 1 meter longer than the 737-100 and offers a single-class capacity of up to 78 with a 2-2 cabin layout. Ultimately, the 737-100 was an important aircraft for Boeing, not really as a money-making bestseller, but as a proof of concept and a launch point for larger variants based on the same platform. What do you think of the progression and development of the 737 going from the Dash 100 to what we see today with the MAX family? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.